Hello gorgeous peeps, this is Chris from Akumbu and I'm here with the Moto Z3 player, or for our American fans, the Z3 player. And we're just going to do a full unboxing setup and a tour of the handset so you know exactly what to expect if you decide to splash out on this latest Moto Mods compatible device. So the Z series or Z series are Motorola's flagship phones. The Z3 player is the more basic of the new Z3 family. It's about to hit the UK. We haven't got a specific release date or price just yet, but hopefully should be out soon after you watch this video. And there's the phone itself. We'll just stick that aside and we'll just check out what exactly else is in the box. So it's quite an exciting little box, this one, compared with a lot of them. A bit more than just your bog standard charger and all that. So obviously the usual readmes and all that shenanigans. And then the interesting stuff is underneath. So you see in this little deposit here, hopefully we've got ourselves one of the Moto Mods. So Moto Mods, for those who don't know, they basically just slap on the back of the Z series smartphones and they just add bonus functionality. So in this case, it is a bit of a bonus power pack action. What this does is basically just a secondary battery, so it supplements the primary battery and it's supposed to give you up to about sort of 3 days of life, which is pretty sweet. So explore that a bit more in a second. What other lovely shenanigans do we have here? We've got a Type-C USB to 3.5mm headphone jack. As you can see, there is no headphone jack here on the Moto Z3 player, so you'll need that if you want to connect some wired phones. You also do actually get some headphones bundled in the box. And even though the Moto Z3 player doesn't have a 3.5mm headphone jack, they are actually 3.5mm headphones. So you're gonna have to actually use that dongle in order to get them on the board. I wonder why they didn't just include some Type-C headphones. That would have been more of a better idea, I guess. I don't know, maybe not. And a bit of 3-pin USB plug and USB charging cable, quel surprise. So there you go, that is what you get in the box. Not a bad little setup. So let's just chuck all this away. One thing I haven't seen is a little pin pokey device to actually get into your SIM tray, which is kind of different. So unless I missed that, you have to provide your own pokey pin device or just use your wife's earrings like I always do. First of all, a little bit more about the Z3 plate itself. It's a 6-inch handset. So as you can see, it's a definitely fills the hand quite nicely there. Let's just peel off this bit of sticker action. See if it's got any juice in the tank. If I can locate the power button, there it is. Yeah, we do have some power already in there, so that's good. As you can see, the screen does mostly fill the front of the panel. You do get slightly thick bezels down the left and right hand side, but they're nice and slender up top and down below. And as you can see, no notch action as well, which pretty much makes the Z3 player a standout icon of 2018. No notch. What are you doing, Motorola, you crazy mofos? The actual phone itself has got a glass front and a glass back end, as you can see here as well. So as you can see here, glass front, I believe it's Gorilla Glass 3, and a glass back as well, with a nice bit of aluminium banding, Series 6000 aluminium around the edging as well. Nice slim, compact form, as you can see here, without any Moto Mods attached, although the old camera lens does jut forth from the back end there, as you can see. And what happens is you can just slip a Moto Mods on at any point, like so. It just hooks up there magnetically. As you can see, this Power Pack 1 adds quite a bit of girth to your handset, but it does also apparently add quite a lot of battery life on there as well. So definitely worth it if you're going to be going away for a long weekend, something like that. And as you see, when you slap on the Moto Mods, it's nice and easy. Just pops up a little, hey, you've added a power pack. Good for you. As you see there, just explains how exactly to use the Moto Mod. And as you see there, you've got default mode. The phone battery is kept permanently at 100% while it's drawing power from that Moto Mod until, of course, the Moto Mod runs out of power itself and then that'll drain. Let's go for efficiency mode because that just seems to make sense. And of course, when you've got a Moto Mod on, that'll just add a different texture to the back end of the phone. So you see, you no longer have that glass finish. Now it's a nice, smooth, matte textured finish instead. Actually, probably a bit better for the grip. Certainly adds a good bit of heft to it as well. It's 156 grams without the Moto Mods, and then obviously this power pack will add probably another extra, I'm gonna go for 90 to 100 grams, so it's got a serious heft to it right now, definitely. And the Moto Mods can just be pulled off again like so, without disrupting the use of the phone or anything like that as well. And then as you see, you're back into your nice slender glass finish. And it's actually P2I rated splash resistant as well, so don't go dropping it in the toilets or anything like that. But it can take a, yeah, you know, a heavy thunderstorm, or if you know, you're getting splashed by your kid when they're in the bath, something like that, no worries at all. As mentioned before, there is of course no 3.5mm jack, but you do get your Type-C for charging and of course the dongle in the box. You get your power button over here on the left hand edge. Over on the right edge, you've got your volume keys, and then up top the SIM tray. which also sports micro SD memory cards of up to 2 terabytes. Good luck finding one of those. One of the more interesting aspects of the Moto Z3 Player's design is the fingerprint sensor here on the side. One of the more interesting aspects of the Moto Z3 Player's design is the side-mounted fingerprint sensor, something we've only really seen on Sony phones up to this point. Sony's actually ditched that now to go for a weirdly positioned rear-mounted sensor instead. So it's quite interesting to see Motorola now adopting that strategy. We do quite like it on the side because, as you say, if you just pick it up like so, your thumb just naturally falls onto that scanner. Or of course, if you are left-handed, your little pinky here will land on that scanner and just for quick and easy unlocking. So let's get it all set up now anyway. So of course, the sensor is located on the side here, and we're just gonna keep on tapping and tapping and tapping, get it all set up. Of course, Sony's fingerprint sensor was always a built-in power button as well, so it's kind of weird to have that separate power button on the side there, but there is no problem at all, because all you need to do is just tap that sensor, and as you can see, you're straight into the Moto Z3 Player. No hanging around, you don't need to push the power button first or anything, just tap, and we're straight into the handset. Awesome. So you might be wondering, why even have that power button? Well, obviously, if you've got gloves or something on, then you're not going to be able to use that fingerprint sensor. Luckily, Motorola has you sorted. You don't have to enter pins or anything like that, anything archaic. This is 2018 after all. What you can do instead is dive back into that security section, and as you'll see, there's a bit of face unlock action on the Moto Z3 Player as well. So let's get that all set up. Allow. All right, I'm just gonna align my face. Okay, so hopefully that's done the job. And then as you can see, you can bypass the lock screen, which is definitely what we want to do. So you can just literally just lift it. It will read your face automatically and then unlock your smartphone, which is lovely stuff. As you can see, if you press the power button now, it should hopefully, boom, there we go, automatically scan your face and just bypass that lock screen. And hopefully, as the lighting is kind of like ambient in this room, hopefully in a brightly lit area, it'll be basically straight in, instant access. But hopefully it'll work well in low light environments as well, similar to the likes of the OnePlus 6, the P20, all that kind of stuff. Great facial recognition on all of those phones, and hopefully Motorola's baby will do the same. So let's talk a bit more about the phone specs. So as I mentioned before, it's a 6-inch screen, or according to Motorola's official specs, it's 6.01 inches. Kind of taking the mickey there now, Motorola. Let's just call it a 6-incher, shall we, and be done with it. It's a full HD panel, so as you can see, nice and crisp as well. If we get in there nice and close, you can see no problem with all those little tiny bits of text, nice and crisp. You'll not be noticing any individual pixels or anything like that. And the colors are nice and punchy as well, because it's an OLED panel, which is absolutely stunning stuff. So definitely one of the sort of more affordable OLED smartphones out there. Dive into display, let's see how much customization we actually have. So as you can see, you can dive into color mode. It's a set to vibrant by default, but you can dive back into standard if you don't want to give those colors that extra bit of oomph. And that's pretty much it in terms of your display customization. It should be nice and bright as well though, so if we just bump it all the way up to maximum brightness, and then yeah, you should have no problem at all seeing that out of doors. Good viewing angles and everything as well, as you would expect from one of the Z series smartphones. I mean, even the G's and everything have gorgeous displays on them, and Moto E, 100 quid, nice little panel on that as well. So not surprising to see a really stunning OLED screen on this Moto Z3 Player. And of course, as mentioned before, no notch. Yeah, baby. One of the great things about Motorola smartphones as well is if you like a nice clean bit of Android, the good thing is you'll get it here on the Motorola. So if we dive into system, you'll see here we're running Android version 8.1.0, and Motorola hasn't really done any tinkering with that. It's your bog standard basic vanilla Android software. So yes, you see, pull down the notifications bar, looks very familiar. And all of the general settings you'd expect to see are packed away in there. Motorola has added some bonus bits though in the form of the Moto app. So it's all separate from the actual OS itself, as you can see. We dive into it, yeah, continue, allow all the general permissions, all the usual fun shenanigans, yes. Now first of all, the Moto app now gives you suggestions on how to get the most from your smartphone, which is quite handy, especially if you've never used an Android device before, or especially a Motorola device with some of these bonus bits. And if we dive into features, you'll see you've got some bonus bits in here as well. So as you can see, we've got Moto Voice, which is basically just another voice activated assistant. It's actually pretty decent if you're just gonna be in the car, you just wanna read out a message, send a message, something like that. Moto Display, you've got some bonus customization for that OLED panel in here. So for instance, the night display is basically just a blue light filter, just makes everything nice and easy on the eye. You can schedule it so it only turns on at night, of course. So as you can see here, it will start automatically at 10 p.m. end automatically at 8 a.m. I actually get up quite a bit before that because I've got a 3-year-old. So let's start that at stop that at 6:30. Moto Actions is pretty good too as well. It adds basically a whole bunch of gesture support. So we've got some new stuff in here that I haven't seen in some of the previous models. So for instance, the media controls, as you can see there, when the screen is off, just press and hold the volume up or down button to actually skip tracks, which is quite a neat little feature. You can do your 3-finger screenshots, quick and simple. That's always quite handy to do. So all you need to do is just tap and hold, and there you go. One button navigation, something a bit different as well. If you want to just ditch this navigation bar down beneath, you can turn that on. And what it does is it just uses simple gestures instead. So as you can see, you can tap once to go home, swipe to go back, swipe right for the recent apps, and hold to launch the Google Assistant. It's not necessarily any better, it's just a different way of doing things. One of our favorites is the swipe to shrink screen feature, something that's a bit of a tongue twister, so I always balls that one up, and I managed to do it first time this time, hooray! And basically, because the Moto Z3 Play is a bit of a meaty 6-incher, it can be a bit difficult to handle at times, especially it's got that slippery glass back. So if you have only got the one hand spare, all you need to do is drag from the center of the screen to the corner. It always takes me a few efforts to actually get the hang of it again whenever I've not been using a Moto for a while. But as you can see, it just shrinks down the entire screen. You can actually use your apps in this mode and everything as well. So it's nice and straightforward. Very good for pulling down, God, as he says, completely muffing it up. Good for pulling down the notifications tabs, that's good. So it just makes life that little bit easier. Now, power on the show is a Snapdragon 636 chipset backed by 4 gigs of RAM. So it's a basic mid-range Qualcomm platform. Should hopefully do the trick all right. The 636s we've used in the past have been fine. The odd little stutter and stammer here and there as you do load up an app, but on the whole, it's fine. You can play the likes of PUBG Mobile, not on top detail levels, but sort of medium detail levels with a decent frame rate. So then certainly for your everyday tasks, absolutely no worries at all. Where we're hoping the Moto Z3 Play really excels is the battery life, because it's got a 3000 milliamp cell, and then of course if you get your old Moto Mods on the go, that's going to boost it even further. So I'll definitely be fully testing this out, so stay tuned for an in-depth review. As you can see, you've got usual battery saver modes and everything, and of course you can get a bit of wireless charging as well if you buy the specific mod for that, so if that's your bag, then no worries. And with a bit of turbo power support, you should hopefully charge up again in next to no time. And then rounding off the specs, you've got your storage, you've got either 32 or 64 gigs, depending on which model you buy. As you can see here, this is the 64 gig model. So you've got about 50 gigs free to play around with, because I haven't bothered installing any new apps or anything just yet. So quite a bit of space to play around with your media. And as I say, supports microSD memory cards up to 2 terabytes, so done. Which brings us nicely onto the camera tech. As you can see here, you've got a dual lens rear snapper. So what we've got is a 12 megapixel primary lens, f1.7, so hopefully should prove fine for those low light shots. And that's backed by a simple 5 megapixel depth sensor. So just to help out with those portrait shots, give you a nice bit of background bokeh blurred effect. So we dive on into the camera app. It's Motorola's standard affair, really. So if you've used a Motorola phone before, you'll basically be right at home. As you can see, you've got your usual toggles along the top here. You can actually dive into a professional manual mode with a quick tap there, and that just allows you to actually tweak the white balancing, ISO levels, everything yourself. So if you actually know what you're doing, then you can get stuck in there, good for you. Otherwise, just stick with the auto mode, which is pretty damn good. Swipe of your finger to the right and you open up the bonus modes. And as you can see here, you've got a full complement to choose from. Spot color's pretty good. I'll grab Mr. Teapot here to demonstrate. Can you tell I've got kids? What we'll do is we'll set him over there, choose spot color, and then just tap to select a specific color that you're taking a picture of. So as you can see here, I've given Mr. Teapot a tap. Now, all it will pick up on in terms of the colors is that specific shade of pink. So everything else gets blurred out to a nice sort of monochrome effect. It doesn't quite work perfectly. As you can see here, you do get some sort of discoloration here and there, but you can actually tweak it back a little bit with a play around of this little slider to get it so it looks basically just about right. And of course you can fully reset at any point and have a bit of a play around until you get it just right, and then just tap that and you take a funky shot. Quite like portrait mode as well, as was mentioned before, that just uses both lenses to lock onto your subject, keep them nice and crisp while blurring out everything behind them. Adds quite a nice funky effect, helps them to really stand out and look very cool indeed. And in terms of the video, you can shoot up to 4K resolution video at 30 frames per second. As you can see, you've got a bit of image stabilization as well. Otherwise, you can just stick with the default full HD at either 30 or 60 frames per second. And you've also got the option to shoot slow motion and time lapse Mods video, or you can jump into my YouTube live as well if you want to do a live streaming to everyone's favorite video service. Just let the world know how awesome your life is, do whatever you want to do. And you can also swap to the 8 megapixel front facing camera with a quick tap down there. It's an f2.0 aperture lens. It should be sort of okay as long as you're not in any sort of murky restaurant, bar, strip club, whatever you kind of service you like to frequent. Just take a quick selfie there. And yes, another keeper for sure. I've got to stop doing that while I'm talking. It never ends well. And that right there, in a nutshell, is the Motorola Moto Z3 Play. It's quite a nifty little smartphone, as you can see. There's 6-inch OLED screen, nice and bright and colorful, so pretty good for your media chops and all that. Plenty of storage, especially helped along by that micro SD if you do want to carry along a lot of movies and everything as you roam about. Hopefully that 3000 milliamp cell will keep you going all day long. Pretty impressive they've got that in there, despite how slender this thing is. And of course, the fact that you've got your Moto Mods support means you can slap on an extra battery, you can slap on the projector. There are quite a few funky Moto Mods available now, so you know, buddy for Motorola for keeping up with the Moto Mods strategy. Really, really good to see something sort of go across a number of generations now and still going strong. And they are actually genuinely well crafted, some of them. So yeah, definitely an intriguing USP. So are you tempted by the Moto Z3 Play? Definitely let us know in the comments down below. Be great to hear your thoughts. Looking forward, obviously, to having to play with the full-on Moto Z3. And you can expect some more Motorola handsets to be launching before the end of the year, so stay tuned for all of that right here on Rekombu. And don't forget to poke that subscribe button to be the first to see the latest and greatest mobile tech. Cheers, everyone. Love you.